He's served millions of American families in recent years. A fruit tip gives you over 2,000 calories a day, which is what your body needs under stress to survive. We ship fast and discreet to your door. You'll have your food within days, too, not weeks or months. Our mission is your survival. Our food could definitely be a lifesaver when the peanut butter hits the fan. But don't wait. It's time to act. Go to MyPatriotSupply.com. MyPatriotSupply.com.
And welcome back to Coast to Coast. George Norrie with the story. Spanya back with us, of course. Her website link up at coasttocoastam.com. At the end of the program, we'll tell you about some free gifts she's got available for you as well. Ascension and awakening of humanity. Tell me what that means.
Well, humanity is undergoing a massive shift of consciousness right now. So we're in a very early part of that phase, which actually I would say began in the 60s, the 1960s, with, you know, the birth of the hippie movement, and that was the initial awakening, you know, sort of the awakening. And it's been suppressed a lot. It's been held back. There's a lot of attempts to sort of hold us back, but it's gone. It's happening, and we're having huge wake-up calls. We can see that in the external reality, and our old reality is in a process of collapse, while a new reality and in all new elements of this new reality are being birthed. And they're happening simultaneously, and it's happening across all of our systems and structures, you know, politically, in terms of our geography, in terms of our schooling systems, our medical systems, our financial systems, everything. And internally, personally, we're beginning to realize that the external world is a reflection of the internal world. So we're making a shift from external living, where we believe everything is entirely physical, to internal living, where we realize everything in the external world will be changing for the better as we change from the inside out.
Is that what you mean by third versus fifth dimension?
Yeah, the third dimension is this old paradigm that's a field-based paradigm that's entirely based in physicality. And in the third dimensional paradigm, we're living in a hierarchical, patriarchal, oligarchical, you know, system and structure that's based in service to self, you know, thinking about the self to the harm or detriment of the many, regardless of how the many may be hurt. And in this system, we basically, this old system, you know, external authorities, we give our power to external authorities. And in the new system, as it's being birthed, we reclaim our power as we recognize that everything is within us and that we have the ability to make change. But the reclamation of that power must come through a process of discovering from within ourselves our sovereign ability to come into a sort of divine neutrality, where we no longer polarize, where we realize that from within us we can change everything through our consciousness.
We live in a third dimension life, don't we, generally?
Yeah, we're living in a physical world, and that doesn't change. What changes is the idea that things in the non-physical don't exist. What changes is we start to realize the non-physical is even more powerful, in a sense, than the physical.
Why do we cut off the dimensions at five? Why not six or seven?
We don't. We don't have to. We're just getting to that sort of jumping off point, because the fifth dimension is where we start realizing, where we start incorporating both physical and non-physical in all our engagements, in everything we do. And we shift out of this fear-based reality and into realizing that everything is love, peace, and joy, and getting out of this polarity of the, you know, I think this is one of those areas that humanity really is going to make the biggest shift. And by the way, this is what the animals are really showing us, that everything is a mirror. Everything. We live in a massive hall of mirrors. So everything we see and perceive in our external world is a reflection of what we see inside ourselves, or what exists within ourselves. So if we shift out of thinking that we're separate from everyone and everything, and we start realizing that we're connected to everyone and everything, because everyone and everything is a reflection of what we see and perceive, and where we vibrate energetically, whatever our vibration is, our energetic signature, that change is how we will have a different experience externally. And that is 5D. That's 5D. But we can go way past that. See, that sixth dimension is like universal laws. That's where the Akashic Records are, by the way. And then when you get into these other dimensional realms, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, that's where all of our benevolent star family races are. Extraterrestrials, right, who are benevolent. Not those old, like, you know, grays and those ones who are much more brass, reptilian. Those are much more 3D based. And so we don't have to stop at 5. To answer your question, it goes way beyond that. It's potentially infinite, but we're just learning how to access, you know, mostly to anchor ourselves in 5D, where we no longer operate from just this total separation and polarity. Does that make sense?
It does. It does.
Yeah.
Does science look at this too?
I think that that's a big discovery right now. Science is trying to figure out the fact. But quantum physics gets it, right? Any quantum physicist gets this. That from a quantum physicist perspective, all it is just awareness. It's just non-physical energy that has a vibrational rate, right? Everything is vibrational consciousness. So, you know, from quantum physicists, from that perspective, they get it. But where science doesn't get it is that old Newtonian type of science that still, like, Western medicine is still following, and our old science books and schools, you know, medical systems are still following that old system. Does that make sense?
Corey, one of our favorite words, consciousness. Explain to us what you believe consciousness to be.
Well, what I would like people to know is even beyond consciousness is pure awareness. In reality, all of us, every one of us is pure awareness. And it is our awareness that perceives our reality. And consciousness is just the degree to which we are consciously aware of what we are perceiving and how we are interpreting that, and then what we do with our interpretation. So this is, again, this is a major part of what animals are really helping us with, because their awareness, they don't have to analyze their experience, they just have consciousness about what they perceive. So if they feel something, or sense something, or they pick up on something that their human is experiencing, or they pick up something that's going on in the earth, they have a knowing, an awareness of it, and their awareness is so pure, it doesn't require any analyzation. So the more, to me, the more conscious we are, the more conscious we are, the more consciously aware we are, the more we are consciously able to change our perspective to something that we desire it more to be.
Where does DNA fit into this?
Where the DNA fits into this is that our old paradigm is operating with two strands of DNA, right? Our genetics and basically the ancestral stories that are passed down, right? That's what we inherit. And what we're starting to do in this new paradigm now is awaken and activate what's been dormant, that science has called, up until 2012, we called it junk DNA, the additional 10 strands. We called it junk. In 2012, enough credible scientists published in credible scientific journals that additional 10 strands are not junk, that in fact they're just dormant, waiting to be awakened. And they're trying to determine what that is, and that's why there's just so much desire to capture DNA right now, because people are trying to study what is this DNA good for. But the higher truth of it is that people are starting to realize is that this DNA has all kinds of solutions for basically whatever's going on in humanity's world. So codes, we have information in that DNA. For example, and this is not studied by science, they're not known yet, to my knowledge anyway, that we have codes of immunity and imperviousness in there. Immunity and imperviousness to anything, virus, any kind of virus. But it needs to be activated. And the way we activate it is with our consciousness. We have to first be aware that it's in there. Otherwise, it's just dormant. Junk. Considered formerly called junk, but now dormant, right? So once we become aware that it's there, with our consciousness, we can actively engage in awakening it. And then we start walking around, the DNA starts sending information to the embodied, the body, the physical form, that it's immune and impervious to any and all forms of virus, for example, or any shedding, or even 5G. But this is just, this part's not known by science. They don't know it yet. Not to my knowledge.
They're baffled, aren't they?
I think that's what they're trying to figure out. I think that's why, like, there's a lot of, DNA in me, ancestry in me, a lot of these DNA collection organizations are being purchased by the CIA. Why? Because they're trying to study the DNA to figure this stuff out. But in reality, these people who are, like, of this old paradigm, who basically their primary agenda is service to self at the harm and expense of the many, that they really can't figure it out. They're not going to be able to. Because the fascinating thing about this DNA is that it will not be revealed for purposes of harm or detriment to others. It can only be revealed through the personal process of awakening through love. That's why within the heart center, of every human, funny thing is, like, if you know the chakras, we've probably talked about this lots of times,
sure.
that center has, as an energy center, is the only energy center that has two colors, vibrationally speaking. So that's because it connects us with the old paradigm. It's like a portal to the new paradigm. And in order to activate these higher strands of DNA, and also in order to access the higher dimensional realms that you mentioned earlier, we have to go through the heart center. We have to go through the compassionate love in our own heart center. So in other words, somebody who's trying to access this information for the harm to many, they won't be able to find it.
What is
literally written in there?
What is your definition of a starseed?
My definition of a starseed is someone who knows themselves as a being who's connected to the stars, to benevolent star families.
Aren't we our stars? Are all of us starseeds in some way?
I think we are all. I think that is the kind of the running, in a way, like I say it, like this with a little bit of jest. It's sort of like a little bit of a joke. Like we are, planet Earth is the planet of all interdimensional races from all kinds of star planetary bodies, and that's what's encoded into the DNA. All of our lineage from not only the past in our human reality and even prior to that, but into the future, who we evolve into. And that includes the star family races who are most benevolent, who are helping us from the higher dimensional realm.
That's pretty dramatic. Well, why doesn't science get into this?
It is dramatic. It is so dramatic. But this is part of the shift. It's so progressive that it's hard for us to believe. You know, it's so out there. And yet, in progressive communities like this, we're more open-minded. We're trying to discover this. But of course, you're right. Science doesn't have this validated yet. And we do hope that they'll be able to validate it, because still, so many people, that's what we look to believe that something is real.
Interesting take. We're going to take calls next hour with Lori. That includes, of course, talking about animals, the afterlife, telepathy, and human awakening as well. Since you've been doing this, have you come across anything dramatic in your own personal life?
Yeah. How much time do you have? One of the most amazing things that happened very recently, actually, was I lead retreats in Arkansas and over the crystal waters there, and I've been doing this for a number of years. In one year, I was there on the lake bed, and while I was just sitting, I wasn't even in deep meditation, really, not at all, but just lightly, just relaxing over the lake, where all the crystals are, because they are basically record keepers holding knowledge and information from from not only our past, but also into our future. I saw like blasts of light coming both up from the lake and basically in a way down into the lake. And I saw these windows or what I would call like portals or doorways opening and closing all over the lake. This did not happen for just 30 seconds. This went on for hours. And as they did, I could see these light codes being dropped down into the lake, which I could understand was going into the crystals, and at the same time coming up out from the crystals. It was like portals opening. When I asked this just psychically, because again, whenever we're dealing with psychic information, most of the time we don't have scientific evidence of this stuff. But what I was told was, this is where the star beings come. This is one place so that we can put this information and knowledge into the crystals, encode it like record keepers, so that people can access it when they start working with crystals. And because the crystals do help activate DNA for people.
When they learn how to do this, they can do amazing things, can't they?
Yes, I think what my knowing is that we have the solutions to all of our problems stored up within ourselves, within our own DNA. And that's why the DNA, again, is such a prized possession right now. It's the most prized possession on Earth.
Book's still available?
We have. Is it still available?
Your book.
Oh, sorry? Say that again?
Are your books still available?
Oh, they're on Amazon.
Okay. Amazon has them all, right? All right, well, stay with us, Laurie. We're going to come back in a moment here and take questions regarding animals, telepathy, human consciousness, you name it, we've got it. In just a moment on Coast to Coast AM, her website is her name, linked up at coasttocoastam.com.
Find out more about tonight's guest. Log on to coasttocoastam.com.
Through college? Is that
yeah, I'll come over and help.
Okay. Wait, what class would you teach?
I would teach
Gary and Shannon.
What's the wine tasting?
Wine tasting? Weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
Why would a plumber just tell me what it costs to unclog my drain over the phone? Is it that complicated?
No, it's not. It makes no sense at all. They obviously have a price.
Whoa, you've got a nice aroma. Who are you?
Mike Diamond, the Smell Good Plumber.
Will you tell me how much sun's out my drain?
$99.
But you haven't seen it.
Don't need to. Doesn't matter if it's a kitchen sink or a mainline sewer stoppage. The Smell Good Plumbers at Mike Diamond will unclog almost any drain for $99.
Almost?
Yeah, there are a few exceptions, but you can read all about them on our website before you call. Just go to thesmellgoodplumber.com.
Wow, you're like upfront and everything. I just called a guy named Bubba who wouldn't tell me anything.
No Bubba's here, ma'am. Just professional plumbers who show up on time, smell good, and unclog drains for $99. Call us, 1-800-446-MIKE.
Contact your license number, 399-170.
Paid actor endorsement. Individual rates, coverage offerings, and savings may vary. Subject to terms and conditions. Not available in all areas. As a small business owner, I'm trying to build my business while keeping costs down. So imagine my surprise when I heard Pi Insurance on the radio saying I might be overpaying for workers' comp. Pi said they could save small businesses like mine up to 30% on workers' comp coverage. It sounded simple. So I went to trypi.com, got a quote in 3 minutes, and ended up saving thousands. Pi Insurance is a breath of fresh air. Their team put me at ease by explaining my policy and making sure I only paid for what I needed. It felt great to know I was protecting my employees while saving money. It's easy to see why Pi is rated excellent on Trustpilot by customers. If you're a small business owner, check out Pi Insurance for workers' comp. Ask your agent for Pi. or see how much you can save in 3 minutes at trypie.com. That's TRYPIE.com.
At Sit and Place, we know that people are experts at all kinds of things, except one, how to shop for the right mattress.
Right, Dad. Shopping for a mattress isn't something you do every day, or even every 8 years.
That's why Sit and Place has mattress experts with an average of 10 years experience, and bed mesh technology that scientifically recommends just the right mattress for you.
So for expert advice, trust your sleep to Sit and Place.
You know, Drew, I'm an expert at other things.
Like what?
Screaming free!
The news has been updated. Click to refresh.
KFI and KOST HD2, Los Angeles, Orange County.
It's time for your morning wake-up call. Here's Jennifer Jones Lee.
Tuesday in September. September always goes by so quickly. I don't know what it is about the 30-day month. One month day. And yet they throw me for a loop. Hope you're having a good start to your day, though. Here's what's up on your wake-up call. SoCal Gas has agreed to a big payout to more than 35,000 people affected by a gas leak in Aliso Canyon in 2015. The DEA says fentanyl-laced fake pills are becoming such a problem that three-quarters of all drug-related deaths this year in L.A. will happen because of them. And health experts say the number of kids testing positive for COVID-19 is going down a little, but kids still make up the greater amount of new cases. 5:05, we'll talk with ABC's Karen Travers. So the president got his COVID booster shot yesterday live on TV. He was hoping to encourage people to get the shot who are eligible. And while that part seems to have gone so far so good, no government, no movement there when it comes to the president's economic agenda. Unless maybe you say Republicans blocking the bill to keep the government funded is actually a step back. So we've got lots to unpack with Karen in just a few minutes. So let's start with some of these stories coming out of the KFI 24-hour newsroom. SoCal Gas and its parent company, Sempra Energy, are getting ready to pay $1.8 billion to people affected by the gas leak in Aliso Canyon in 2015.
Two retired judges will evaluate each of the more than 35,000 cases to see how much money and damages is owed. Attorney Raymond Boucher says the leak had a monumental impact on the community.
Everybody went to Porter Ranch because it's a beautiful place to live. It's a great place to raise your kids and raise a family. And so all of a sudden, for 118 days, people are, pushed asunder and forced to leave their homes.
He says people reported symptoms including vomiting and headaches. The settlement was announced yesterday. Blake Trolley, KFI News.
The DEA says fentanyl-laced fake pills are still a problem with young people in the L.A. area.
They look like normal prescription meds, but the DEA's Bill Bodner says they have enough fentanyl in meth to kill a person with a single pill. He says in 2019, one-third of all drug deaths were from fentanyl. Last year, it was a half.
And this year, we're on pace that it's going to be either two-thirds or three-quarters of all the deaths. Drug deaths are caused by fentanyl.
Bodner says the fake pills are made and shipped from Mexico, and younger people are the biggest consumers because the pills can easily be bought via social media and online. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
Nearly 60,000 pot-related convictions in L.A. County will soon be dismissed. L.A. County D.A. George Gascon made the announcement yesterday following an investigation into county court records. He says records related to the convictions will also be sealed.
We know that I chose to win complete release. It's not fully achieved unless you seal the record. So I'm very excited that we are actually going one step further.
Gascon says there were also 66,000 pot convictions in L.A. County that were thrown out last year in cases investigated by the state. Health experts say the number of kids testing positive for COVID-19 is going down a little, but kids also make up the greater amount of new cases. The American Academy of Pediatrics says the number of COVID cases among kids went down 225,000 to 206,000 last week, but kids still account for nearly 27% of cases nationwide. A study by Kaiser Permanente says most kids in SoCal put on weight during the pandemic. Kids don't feel bad. Who didn't? Researchers say they compared about 200,000 kids from 2019 to last year. They found the kids aged 5 to 11 gained 5 extra pounds, and 16 to 17-year-olds gained 2 extra pounds on average. Researchers say the weight gain led to a 9% increase in kids in the younger age group being considered overweight and obese. All right, we come back. We're going to talk with ABC's Karen Chavers about the president getting his booster shot, and does that really encourage people to go out and get there? And also we'll talk about the president's economic agenda and Republicans blocking that bill that would keep the government funded. So where do we stand on that now? All that's coming up. But right now, let's say good morning to Nick. Nick, how's it going?
Good morning, Jen. It's going to be a messy one first thing this morning. Get to the Longview area, northbound side of 710 at Willow. That crash that has all northbound lanes shut down. It is a fatality crash investigation, and your drive packed in tight on the northbound side of the 710 as you come away from Anaheim Street. So you'll definitely need to plan ahead for an alternate to get to the 405. Getting out of Longview area right now. Cherry looks good. Atlantic, Longview Boulevard, nothing major for your drive there. Also, if you're traveling out of the more so, well, the Terminal Island area, Port of Long Beach and Wilmington area, heading northbound along Alameda to the 405, which is Santa Fe, actually, will look pretty good for you. Same story for Wilmington Avenue. Got an update on this or anything else slowing down your drive? Town 250 on the cell phone. Keyword is KFI traffic. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Colliottini.
506 on your wake-up call, KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Karen Chavers, good morning to you. So the president got the boost on TV yesterday.
He did, as he said he was going to do, and as he did for his other shots of the Pfizer vaccine. So the president yesterday, 8 months and 16 days after his second shot, got his third shot, the booster shot. And just to kind of emphasize how easy it is to get it and not hurt, not painful. He talked the entire time he received the booster. He was taking questions from reporters because he couldn't really go anywhere as he sat down in that chair. The president made the point that he is way, way over the eligibility. The 65 and older group, he can get the boosters right now. But he also said, you know, this is about people getting their boosters, but also the unvaccinated, going out and getting that first shot. There's such an emphasis from the president and the administration, noting that about a quarter of Americans still are not vaccinated, and he says that number has to come down.
Even if he says that, there are still people who say, no, I'm not getting it, period. I don't care what you say. I don't care if I see you get the shot on TV. What does he hope to, I guess my question is, how do you get those unvaccinated people vaccinated if they genuinely feel, I don't want to get vaccinated, I'm scared, or whatever their reasoning is?
You know, a couple of things the White House would point to. One is to make sure people know how easy it is, how accessible, because they say they're still hearing from people who say, I don't know if I can take the full day off from work, or I don't know where to get it, or I don't want to wait for it, and that you can just go to a pharmacy or your doctor even and get the shot. Other thing that the White House continues to say, and I've had exchanges with Jen Psaki at the White House press briefing about this, is that sometimes they recognize the president's not the best messenger. So people are not going to watch that and say, well, now I'm going to go get my shot. Or if they hear from the president that would change their mind. But I really think this has to come to some people, from family, from friends, from neighbors, from a community leader that they know and trust. And that for some people, it's an experience going through it. If you see a family member or neighbor or friend go through a first case or a breakthrough case, that maybe that would make you realize you should get it for the protection.
All right. Well, that all makes sense. And I just read a story this morning. San Bernardino County, more than a third of eligible residents still have not received one single dose of COVID-19 vaccine. And that's where you saw... It's very political. I mean, I think that a lot of people that I've spoken with in that county, I just moved to that county this last year. That's what they say. They say they're tired of getting this pushed down their throat. They want it to be their choice, that kind of thing. And so you're right. I'm so glad that she addressed that and that you asked her about the president being the one to be the messenger on this. And some people are so opposed. They're like, who cares if he gets it? We're not doing it.
Yep. Absolutely. You know, I think they'll say that if the president gave a speech every hour of every day, he might not move a needle at all. But somebody else could move that needle by having more direct contact. The other thing, I don't think I mentioned this, the other thing that they're saying will drive that number up is mandates. That businesses are going to say, you've got to do this. That, you know, either as an employee you have to do this, or in order to come in here you have to be vaccinated. But that is going to potentially change the numbers. But of course, that's still kind of a slow roll across the country in terms of where that's happening and how many places it's happening.
Okay, and real fast before you go, the government shut down. I know that Republicans blocked a bill that would keep the government funding. Yeah. What's next?
Yeah, they're going to try it again. It's not clear how or when they'll do it, but the funding runs out at midnight. This bill had a government funding component, but also had the inclusion to raise the debt limit, and that's what Republicans are opposed to, saying that the Democrats want to raise the debt ceiling to do their trillions of dollars in spending, then they should do it themselves. The Democrats are firing back and pointing out that that nearly 98% of the debt is from before President Biden took office, and so much of that, a large chunk of that, trillions, was during the Trump administration from the tax cuts and spending bills. So they say Republicans have a responsibility now to raise that credit limit.
All right, Karen, thanks so much. Talk to you tomorrow.
Have a great day.
You too. See you later. ABC's Karen Travers. And I don't know. I mean, we're at a point. I even have friends who received the COVID-19 vaccine, both of them got both shots. And they're like, you know, the booster right now, no, I'm good. And they're very tired of seeing on TV, get vaccinated. If you don't get vaccinated, you're the problem. That almost makes them more indignant. And I'm just wondering if, it's such a tough line. Do you continue to finger point and make those who don't get vaccinated the bad guys, or at what point do you say, okay, that is your choice, and then just let the chips fall where they may? If you get COVID-19 and it turns out to be a really bad case of it, well, that's on you, because you chose not to get the vaccine, and you let people run that risk. And as far as the mandates go, I wonder if this is going to get brought up in court. I was thinking about this last night. I can't think of a place that says you must have vaccine to come to work. Okay. I wonder if somebody is going to pick it up and say, hey, you're not making sure that my client is vaccinated from the flu to come to work, so why would you make them get vaccinated from COVID-19?
Right.
This is a question. Explain and handle. That's a would they have a case. Not even a do they, but a would they. A woman's been shot by a school safety officer near a high school in Long Beach. Cop safety officer has responded to a fight involving several people when they tried to leave in a car and she shot at them. This happened about 3 yesterday afternoon around Milton High School. It was all caught on cell phone. The school says no students were shot was taken to the hospital for medical condition. Yellow Police Commission will review a report from the police department outlining an $18.5 million plan to improve how it handles protests and civil unrest. Earlier this year, 3 reports found the department mishandled aspects of its response to last year's protests against racism and police brutality in the killing of George Floyd in Minneapolis. Police in Orange are looking for a guy who attacked a student at Chapman University. The girl was attacked late last week and says the guy had a skeleton mask on when he walked up as she was on the phone outside her dorm. She said he hit her and groped her. She says she screamed and fought back and the guy took off. Police have increased patrols in the area. Singer R. Kelly is facing life in prison for racketeering and sex trafficking. Kelly was convicted yesterday on all 9 counts following 2 days of jury deliberations. Attorney Gloria Allred, who represents 3 of the women who testified.